What's up, YouTube? Corey here. I'm out in Lakeway, Texas today, outside of Austin. I'm right in the middle of doing a house. There's been some people, so I didn't want to start the video until now. I got a little more private here. I've done two rooms, and there's three to go here. So let me turn the camera around, and we'll take a look at what I've done, and what there is left to go. So here we go. All right, now this is one of the rooms that's been done. Right here, this one, well, this two, actually the living and then the dining over there is coming up right now. It's coming up next, but let's look at what I've already done here. I've done to right here. You can see I did this room in there. So in here was done. And like I said, this area here are yet to be done. I think this is probably the dirtiest. And there's one more room beyond the kitchen back to the left that I believe they may be in right now. So we'll look at that when I get back there. But right now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move a few more of these chairs out of the way. And I got some chairs over there. Gotta find somewhere to put them all. I'm gonna come through here cleaning. I've already moved all these chairs here over there. So I've got to move a few more around, and then I'll be back to show some cleaning. And I'll probably actually elevate the peroxide a little bit for in here, because it needs the extra whitening in here. That's where most of the traffic was. It's been a little more than a year since I was here last doing the cleaning. And when she called the other day and booked it, she asked for the carpet supplier I go through to do all my repairs. She's going to have them come out, I believe, Monday, and tell her what it would be to put wood in all throughout here. She's got two older dogs waiting for them to, I guess, pass away is how you would say that. Kind of sad, but waiting to see how much longer they're gonna be with her before she does anything else with the flooring. But anyway, I like to send other people business, and the people that take such good care of me with all of my clientele, I like to send them business too. All right, I'll check in here in a bit. Bring up something that I haven't. I've been at this for 3 years on YouTube, and I've never brought this up before because this doesn't come up very often. But when you're cleaning with a machine that weighs close to 100 pounds, that's orbiting, it makes vibrations. So when you're cleaning next to something like this, at any point in time, any of these can take off and start crawling across those glass shelves and crash to the bottom. So that is something that you want to be careful about when you're cleaning with an orbital machine around china that's displayed like that. So always be careful that you don't spend too much time around there, because you gotta watch where you're going with a machine, and you can't watch every cup to decide which one's sliding. It's not all that big a deal when you're on concrete like I am now, but if you're upstairs and you're on a wooden subfloor and you have something like this set up there, it's guaranteed you'll knock something off if you don't hurry past this. So I just wanted to show that, because, you know, like I said, I've been on YouTube for 3 years and it hasn't come up yet. So it's not something that comes up every day for sure, but whenever it does, beware. I think that was a monkey. until that door opened up due to the vibration. That's done. I'm going to finish this little part out here, and I'm going to set up the camera on a tripod when I get over here. So I'll be right back. All right, I'll tell you what happened here. I've got all of this pre-sprayed and all of this has been cleaned, everything out in here. Kind of saw me cleaning that. For some reason I can't get the fan to turn back on, but you know, this is one of those things. It turned out really well in there. Now, out here, this has been pre-sprayed like crazy, and it's been groomed in, and I also switched to a brand new bonnet. The other one was too loaded down to take on the soil that was over here, so I put a new one on it, and this is already lightening up. When you groom the peroxide in, it starts to lighten the color of this. This was a dirty spot in the whole house, so I'm going to set up the camera here to watch some of this cleaning. I'll start over there, give it a bunch more dwell time over there where the door is at. So basically I'm going to be cleaning from the couch to where you can tell over there where the line's at, by the kind of at the door to the big clock. down to the dirty part here. Alright, this is peroxide. All right, we'll try it like Alright, now I'm going to just finish out the rest of this, groom it all, and we'll have a look. See, the peroxide is starting to sting my fingers where I was spraying it on there a while ago. So you get it on you, it'll starting to bleach your skin out. Not really good, and it will be lighter in an hour when it's dry. Now, when you do an area like this and you wind up treating it with pure 20% 20 volume peroxide have to tell your client, until it's dry, you can't walk through here barefoot. It'll do to your feet what it does to my fingers. Not a huge deal, but definitely a concern. So definitely always let your clients know that. Don't go running through here with bare feet until it's dry. All right, there's one more room to go look at, which they're in that right now. So I've got to go roster everybody up and move everybody around and then do one more room of carpet. So one more coming up. All right, this is the last room. I just finished it up. Got to talking to my client and had to miss all of this here. Let's go take a look at the area after it's dry just a little bit. Yeah, you see when it dries, it becomes lighter. So it's not completely dry yet. It's only dried a little. So as it dries, it will get lighter and lighter. So more than likely it's been brought back. So yay. All right, guys, appreciate you watching the video. I've got a repair to do. I've got to drive across town and do that. I'm in Lakeway now, and that's like an hour from anywhere. Traffic doesn't work in this town. Anyway, thanks for watching, and God bless. I'll see you on the next video.